We always say we find these white spaces and fill them with brown faces. And one of the white spaces was behind the camera. We were realizing that too many of the scripts that were crossing our desk weren't penned by women. The meetings that we were taking, you know, specifically with writers, we wanted to see more.
It's really exciting to be on a new journey. I've been an actor my entire adult life. And as much as I love it, I can't say that there's a whole lot about it that's new. And this all feels so new and yet so comfortable at the same time.
We as a company and we as a brand and organization are here to keep the world laughing together. In order to do that, you have to include a lot of people, and that includes these women, these amazing talented women behind the camera, and that's both on the writer and the director side.
That was a big part with this project, was to give opportunities to people who may not have access to these sort of opportunities, knowing that you are seen, you are heard, you are talented, your talent is recognized.
The process starts as something that it is just an idea inside your own head, and as it makes its way to the page, it's still this secret that you're carrying that only you know about. And then you start to sort of let other people read it, and you start to get notes on it, and then handing it over to the director, and then handing it over to the actors and the crew. It really is watching something come to life. It's like a time-lapse video where you watch like an acorn grow into this mighty oak tree.
We reached out in our network to some of the most brilliant Black actresses, you know, who we knew, Bresha Webb, Gabrielle Dennis, Meagan Good, and invited them to direct. So now you have these brilliant writers, these amazing actresses who, you know, have spent so much time on set, so much time being directed, who can now bring all of those skills to the forefront.
It's crazy because when, you know, I read through the scripts, I knew immediately that this was the one that I wanted to do. Somehow my brain just was like, yeah, Black Karen, that's the one.
So I was on the phone with Meagan last night talking about casting for our film and talking about going to Sundance and how blessed we've been in our careers. And I can't help but kind of look around right now and think to myself, boy, maybe some of that progress really is real, because here I am 5 years later, but this time around I'm a writer and I'm involved in this incredible fellowship that exists for the purpose of supporting Black female comedy writers.
Each of these women will have a first look with our company. Their films are going to be distributed with our partners over at NBCU and Peacock, and one of them is receiving a development deal with NBCU and Peacock for other content to be produced by the company. This was really about making change and making change immediately. Like the time for action is always right now.
There are no shortcuts. As a Black woman, it's especially important that you show up and you know your job, you know a little bit about that job, you know a little bit about that job. It's super important to always bring your A game.
Directing to me is new and it's exciting, and I think even when it gets old, it'll still be exciting, and it's something that I really love it a lot. And I just see myself being 50, 60, 70 years old behind the camera, supporting younger actresses that'll come up behind me.
I feel really lucky that I have a background of being an actor, because all of the hours that I've spent on set have informed me as to what's going on and let me really just focus on the words. And it's been really exciting in a way that I can't explain, that I've not ever felt before. I'm discovering that it's one thing to take someone else's words and perform them. It's a whole other thing to have those words be my own, to be able to hand it over to Meagan and let it be her baby, and hand it over to Bresha and let her bring her talent to it. It's kind of like, I feel like I get to like kick back in this chair and watch my child be born, like some kind of dad in the 50s with a cigar. It's really neat. It gives me hope. I'm going to Sundance Film Festival feeling a lot more hopeful about the future and feeling like the possibilities are enormous for what can be.